Guys, look at here to understand the what is service desk, what is the work kind of stuff, understand the customers in a different manner. So generally, as we know, the customer means, so for example, I purchase a laptop or a computer or maybe a refrigerator or maybe a AC, right? So I am in a sitting in some place, okay? So I purchase something, for example, I purchase a Microsoft operating system and I got an issue, okay? So what I will do? Contact Microsoft Office. Contact a Microsoft Office, so just by telephone, right? So we'll call to the Microsoft Office. I got this issue. So please solve my issue, right? So like that. Or maybe you took some broadband internet connection. You got some issue in that one. Internet is not connecting, or maybe internet is very slow, or it keep disconnecting. So what to do? Contact your service provider, like a BSNL or maybe Airtel, Jio. So many are there, no? So you'll contact that service center. I got this issue, I'm frequently disconnecting, or maybe my internet is not working properly. So like that, we call them and we tell this is a issue. So whatever they do it, so they will do the next steps. We'll talk about the next steps, but first initially understand who is this person and who is this person. This is some organization, okay? So for example, it can be a Microsoft, or maybe it is a BSNL, or maybe it is a Airtel, okay? Or it can be a Reliance, or it can be a Jio, or like that. ACT is also there, right? So like that, it is some internet service provider, their customer care, okay? Or maybe you have a credit card. Okay, now you got some issue with your credit card, okay? Your credit limit is there, but still something issue, you can't able to pay with your credit card. So what to do? Contact customer care, right? So customer care, so this is the issue you are getting. So issues from the customer, sometimes it can be a technical issue or maybe a non-technical issue. But first call go to the customer care. If it is a technical issue, then a technical team will handle that one. Non-technical, like a billing kind of stuff, will non-technical will be handled by like a billing or maybe some account information, maybe at some transfer kind of stuff. So the non-technical team will be handled. So these type of customers are external customers. There are not employees of our organization, and as well as a public customer. Anybody can be a customer here. Okay. Anybody can be a customer here. Okay. So like you buy a laptop from Lenovo or a Dell or a HP. So you are also a customer to Lenovo or a Dell or a HP. You purchase a Samsung mobile. So you are a customer of Samsung mobile. If you are using a Airtel services, 4G services or 5G services, or maybe internet services, you are a customer of a Airtel services. So these are external and as well as a public type of customers. So this is one side of one first part of story, like so customers and organization. Okay, so this point is clear. So who is the customer and who is the organization? When you got an issue, so how we are contact our the relevant organization to solve our problems, right? Guys, do you understand this point?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Just one second. Okay, so next part I will tell, just 1 minute. Okay. Any questions? Okay. So here it is. Next one. This is some organization. Just for example, it is a Vedic Soft. It's an organization. Okay. Here also it is a IT company itself. So then there is a lot of people are working on systems. So what I am doing is like, here is also a unit is called a service desk. Okay, this something like service desk is there. I have a different computers. People are working on a computers or their laptops. Okay, so and different departments there are working. Okay, so what happened, there is a person, so he came in the morning and he started a computer. Okay, here, so what happened, system is not working and he don't know to whom who is the technical people who solve the issue, who will repair the computer. He don't know. He can't go outside and call someone to repair it, right? So within the office only, there is a desktop support engineers are there. So they will come and check the issues. But he don't know who is free now, available now, because a lot of people are working. Okay. So who is available? Who is the next person is available? Who is the person? He don't know. So what he will do, he will send a message to this service desk. He will contact the service desk. So this is the I got some issue. So they will ask question, what is the issue? System is not working. They will ask, do you check the power cable or a power button is there or not? Okay, so like that. So they'll ask some basic questions. He said everything, like everything is powered on, everything is switch is properly, cable is proper. So then service desk people, okay, it may be some internal hardware issue. So they will send this information to service desk people. Okay, sorry, desktop support engineers or server engineers, any belongs to which technical team is issues belongs to that one. Usually desktop means desktop laptops, installation of operating system, installation of applications, issues, different type of issues we'll get, no, network connecting issues or system sometimes won't work, like a loose connections or anything, is be handled by desktop support engineers only. These are desktop support engineers, so they will take. Sometimes we call that one as IT support, but also we can call it as a desktop support people. So these people go to this place and okay, so this person will go to here and find out what is the issue. They fix the issue and they will inform to the service desk, okay, issue is solved now, like that. Okay, so another guy is there. So another person is there. This person got some different issue. That is like, his system is working, but he can't able to receive any mails. Mail communication is not there properly. Okay, so what happened? Mail communication is not there. He will ask like, do you check your inbox or any the relevant questions? And the service desk send a team. Service desk inform to some team like who is handling this mail communication related, or a network engineers, or a system engineers, or a server engineers, like that. So they will send this team to here and verify why this person is not able to communicate with the mail communication is not there. Either it is a email communication through internet means, is a network issue, or maybe it can be a email ID issue, or maybe a password issues, okay, or maybe a configuration related issues. So like that, there is a service desk people understand the issue, inform to the appropriate team. So the team, available team, will go and then fix the issues. Okay, so why I put a very big box is like this one. Okay, so we'll go to another issue also. For example, here is a person. He tried to log in to the server. Okay, so he's in a domain environment. He's trying to log into the system, or a server, or a remote server, or try to access the printer. For example, is I try to access the printer, he's unable to access. So what to do? We'll inform to the service desk. Service desk people ask questions. What is the issue you got it, and what kind of error it is showing, okay, and they will understand and they forward the issue to a particular team, like a server administrator team, or a printer administrator team, like that. Okay, so these people will go and assist this person. So how to get access, or anything like a password required to change, they'll change the password, or access permissions required, like that. So depends upon issue. So then service desk people will understand and forward to the proper technical team. So the technical team will help these people to solve the issue. Okay, so here to understand, if you see these people, I put a boxes and pictures, right? So these people are employees of same organization. Someone send some message, and I don't know who is that. Audio. Okay, now I think it is working. Okay, if you see these people, these are all employees of Vedic Soft only. These are employees of Vedic Soft organization. The service desk people are employees of our organization only, same Vedic Soft organization only. The technical team, this team is also belongs to our organization only. It means the user or a customer. So what we can call these people, like a user, or we can customer, either user or a customer, or a employees of our organization only, employees of our organization only. Next, service desk people also belongs to same organization. Okay, the service desk the technical team I put a technical team, normally you can say a technical support people or a technical team, service desk, IT support, desktop support, sorry, desktop support, IT support, network engineers, server engineers. These are all technical team people. Okay, these are all employees of same organization. Employees of same organizations. Same organization. Okay. Who are the users, service desk people, the technical team also. So these type customers we call it as like a user or a customers. User or a customer we call them as internal customers. Okay, understand guys, who are internal customers. Customer means the user or a customer means people who are working in our organization. Here in internal or internal customer means in our own organization only. Service desk people also employees of same organization as your user or a customer. And technical people also is the same organization only. Okay, we will handle our own organization's issues, problems, servers issues, network issues, or desktop issues or laptop issues. So everything we handle in within our organization only. Okay, who got the issue, who got required a support or a information, those people we call that one as a customers or users. Those are also employees of our organization only. So that is called a internal customers. Again, another message, what it is. Guys, when you send any message, put it in a public. It is quite easy to read. Next, Siri, have to ask one question. Yeah, ask me a question. No problem, ask me.
Sir, as you told that the user slash customer are the internal customers, so
Yeah.
Employees working in the same organization, they are called the internal customer for a technical team.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Yes. Correct. Correct word. Employees who are working in a same organization. These are all internal customer for both service desk, technical team also. Everyone is internal only. I got an issue. I want to access a printer. I'm in a Vedic Soft Hyderabad. For example, I'm sitting in a Vedic Soft Hyderabad. Okay. So I want to take a printout, but I am unable to take a printout. So I contact a service desk. So service desk people in the level if they have a any permission or maybe they will ask a technical team to give access to printer. So now I got a printer access. I can able to take the print. So who am I? I'm an internal customer. I am a customer or a user, but I'm an internal user or a customer. Okay, so that is within the organization only. Again, message, you'll see. It is not, everything is a technical support only. Everything is a support only. That's why I said, even my sister is working in a very big organization as a consultant. Their name is consultant, but they are working in a everything like both cloud computing, that data analysis kind of stuff. So everything there are working, but there the title name is like that only. Okay, it means whenever the issue occurred in a organization, okay, so it's in outside of organization or within a, like I will tell very simple, HCL is a one organization. Directly I will tell, HCL is an organization for a usually network related internet service provider. But if you see, HCL won't provide internet to public people, right? So HCL take care of internet related, means network communication between ATMs, ICICI Bank or Axis Bank, the banking related, or some organization related like a Vedic Soft or NIIT or maybe Microsoft, Wipro, like that. Big organization, they have a network related and one place to another place communication is required. So HCL handle that kind of network. So that is, HCL is one organization and the customers are in a different organization. That example I will tell now. Anyway, this time removing this part. Okay. It is the same thing. My organization is Vedic Soft. Service desk is here only. Otherwise, I will remove everything. I'll try again. Okay. Okay, so this is a service desk. Okay. Actually, a lot of people having a the idea is like technical service desk, technical support, like that. But people look at those job as a very small one. But myself, I will tell, first one is getting into IT is very important. First, IT company is very important. If once you are getting in IT, later you can do whatever, like for your development, you can do whatever it is. But as a fresher, first get inside IT company. Don't worry about whether it is a small job, small salary, or a very big salary it is. If you are waiting for a long time and you can't, if in case, if you are unable to go properly into the IT company, but later it is very difficult to go also. Like me, I never went to any IT company. Now it is Vedic Soft is IT company, but I'm not doing any IT job. Okay, I become a trainer only. Okay. So it is difficult. So don't worry about what title you will get it and all. Once you are inside an IT company, so definitely you can easily go into your own path. You understand how to get into higher positions. Okay, that is one. Next one is, as you ask question like a technique, is it like a technical this kind of stuff? What is it? Service desk or tech support kind of stuff. Okay, the tech support, your job is not to handle any public customer. So like normally we know call center, right? Call center means when someone will call you, like my system is not working. Okay, a random person will call you like my system is not working, my internet is not working, from 1 hour it is not working, what you people are doing now. Okay, so when my problem is solved, where is the right click, why, where is the left click, you won't get that kind of calls. Okay, you don't get it because the organization is not belongs to any public service related kind of stuff. For example, you are working in Airtel. Okay, so you'll get a calls like I recharge 100 rupees, my recharge is gone, I'm not able to get a signal, I'm unable to connect 4G. Like you will get a lot of calls, right? So I'm internet unable to access. So a lot of calls we are getting from the customers. Who is the customer? It's a public customer, that is. Your job is not belongs to them. Okay. And not also that internal customers, because internally also there is another technical team is there. Another team is there. So what I'm going to tell, it is external customers, but in an organizational level. This is some organization. For example, I'll put myself like this is I put one company like Latif TechSoft. This is my organization. I have my infrastructure. Okay, so I have my infrastructure like I have a computers. Okay, this is my organization, and I need a something like a server. But I can't able to maintain this server. Okay, I can't maintain this server. Or maybe I have some other kind of stuff like another servers in my organization, or maybe in a different place. So what I will do, so I can't maintain the infrastructure. I have an infrastructure, but I can't maintain. Okay, I have infrastructure, but I can't maintain. This is also a server, for example. Don't get confused, but infrastructure, anything. Like maybe it is a small server, it is a big server. Okay, like I have infrastructure in my organization, but problem is I don't know any issues occur. I don't have any employees for handling that issues. I don't have any employees for handling that kind of issues. Okay, so I will contact VedicSoft, and I will tie up with the VedicSoft service desk and the technical team. Okay, so what I will do, so when any issues occur here, so the customer is here, and any issues occur, they will directly contact this service desk, and through the technical team we'll get the support. To the technical team we get the support. So everything in IT, no need to maintain by their organization only. For example, you guys know web hosting, right? It means I have a website. For example, this is my website. It's not my website. Just I have some website. Now I want to develop my website. So I'm the organization who developed the website. But I don't know where to store this web data. Okay, I don't have any web server in my organization. So what I will do? So I will go to another organization. If they have a server, put the my website into their server. So publish from their server. So I no need to maintain this server directly by me. Someone will maintain my server. Okay. Server can be in a different organization premises or my organization premises, but which maintained by different organization, not my organization. So I am handling from VedicSoft. Now from VedicSoft, my customer is not an individual customer, the customer by an organization. Customer is an employee of another organization. Okay, this organization ask we have a contract between organization to organization. We have a contract between organization to organization, and this organization will ask, I need this kind of support. I need a support for my desktops, servers, network related. Okay, any issues occur, I will call you, please help us. Okay, so like that. So an organization to organization, so we are having a contract. For us, for VedicSoft, this is external customer. Okay, who is the external customer? External customer is a another organization. So the organization which required support, either desktop support or maybe a network related support or router maintenance or a network device maintenance or internet service maintenance, like that. For example, this is some ISP. What is ISP? ISP, Internet Service Provider. Someone, for example, something like any organizational level, Tikona. Okay, so for example, Tikona is one of the internet service provider, just like BSNL, VSNL, or Airtel, Reliance, HCL, like that. So organizational level, Tikona also provide internet service. Okay. Now, my organization is a VedicSoft. My organization is VedicSoft. VedicSoft required internet service, right? We need internet in organizational level, right? So I will contact this Tikona for my internet services. I contact Tikona for internet services. Okay. So he is a provider of service provider of internet for VedicSoft. For VedicSoft. Now I got some issue. I am the person here. Okay. So I got some issue in internet. In organization level, I got a internet issue. To whom I have to contact? Contact service provider, service desk. Okay, we call to the service desk. Okay, I got this issue. Please solve my issue. Okay, so that is service desk. Okay, call to service desk. For Tikona, I am the external customer. Okay, so from VedicSoft, I am the external customer to Tikona, because Tikona providing internet service to my organization. Like IT company is not alone. Any IT company, either it provide a service to certain customer base and also take the service from some organization. Okay, always understand IT business. Understand IT business. We provide a service. I am an internet service provider. So I provide internet services. To provide internet service provider, I need something. I need some software. I need some billing software. I need a ticketing software. Maybe I need a monitoring related one. Devices required, right? Cables required. Modems, routers, switches. This equipment is required. Computers required. It means I have to take that service from different organization. Okay, like that. So procurement department will be there separately, like to purchase items in organizations. Okay, I'm a web hosting organization, so I will host websites. I don't develop it. I just host the websites. Means I will store the website in my server and I link to your website. So that is a service. So I need a service. I have to purchase a service from other organization, like maybe from Intel or maybe a Lenovo, maybe from Dell, maybe from IBM, like that. So each organization depends upon another organization. So each organization provides certain services, also take the service from different organization. So this is organizational level contract. It is, so also we can call like external customers. Mostly your job is for different organizations are there. Okay, different organizations utilize your services. Okay, your network related services utilized in their organization, means their routers, switches, everything is there in their premises. Okay, but we are maintaining from here. We are monitor any issues, any fixes required, also any automated process is there. Now automation is also one of the thing, right? So we all automate the process. Any issues occur, automatically fix the issue or en route the issues. So this is about your basics of service desk. Okay, so understand service desk. First of all, customers, understand the customers. Next, understand the service desk. Guys, any questions? Internal customers, external customers.
No, sir.
Okay. Actually, service desk, just a name itself, like a service desk, is a single point of contact. Okay, it is a single point of contact. Single point of contact. What is this single point of contact means? Very simple. What are the customer or a user we talking about? Okay. If they got an issue or they required an information, a user or a customer, if they have any issue means some problem they are facing, network issue or desktop issue, laptop issue, or a mail communication issue, or something like a information, they need some information, or maybe they required access permissions. Okay, so they may be access permissions. For example, now it's from last 1 year, it's a corona time, right? So corona time means work from home only, everybody doing work from home. So people who are working on a something on an infrastructure or maybe database, like a Oracle database, SQL database, or maybe web developers, testing people. So entire information stores in a centrally in a organizational level only, right? But we don't have a access permission. We need a VPN communication to access that data, because we are in a home, so there is no direct connection from us to there, right? So then obviously we need access permissions. Okay, so VPN access, data access, like that. Also, I will put a VPN, so it will someone send a photo. Second, guys. Okay, so it can be asking for information, access permissions, or a VPN access for a work from home kind of stuff. They'll contact service desk. So this service desk people ask questions to the customers and send this. Either they solve itself, like there is a levels are there, like a level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3. Okay, different levels of service desk is there. It depends upon customer issue, they will handle like that. Like only it is information is required, or maybe it may be a fixing. For example, I forget my password, so I call to the service desk and service desk people ask questions. So what is the last password you are given, or maybe when is a password you are changed, some question they ask, and immediately they change the password and send the password to us directly. Okay, so it is, sometimes it is very simple, sometimes it is not simple. Sometimes they have to ask a technical team to go to customer and then change the things, or maybe a particular team should be give a permission to do some work. Okay, so like that. So different things are, so whatever it is, initially they do a support, okay? So there's a initial support issues, understand and fixing the issues, okay? Primary troubleshooting or fix the issues compulsory. Level 2 means fixing the issues. Level 3, it means there is no further escalation, it is completely management changing decision kind of stuff. Okay, we'll go to that levels again. And what is this fixing thing? So simply to understand, customer got an issue, they will ask service desk, maybe they will return immediately with a solution, or maybe giving some information or permissions directly, or sometimes it required a technical team to understand this issue and they will give the information. For example, desktop support. If your laptop or desktop having some issues, operating system, hardware, or any application related issues, desktop support people, network engineers, or network engineers or a support, whatever the name it is, okay. If you have some network related issues, internet related issues, VPN access related issues, okay, so IP addressing issues, so those people will handle this network related issues, server engineers, okay, like that. So different teams are they will escalate the issue to the particular team, and the team will handle your issues. So for both technical team and customers, single point of contact is service desk. Okay, so here it is. There is a functions of service operation. This is actually ITIL, ITIL, one of the PPT, one part is service operations. We'll discuss this ITIL completely once again, but we'll discuss this service operations first of all completely. But look at these two things, functions of service operations. One is a service desk, another one is a technical management. Guys, read this one and go through once. Okay, so if you want you can note down also, no problem. Okay, now take a just a 10 minutes break. Okay, I will mute for it just a 5 minutes or 10 minutes. So just go through these two things and note down is always a better option. So instead of taking pictures, better to note down this one. I will keep this screen like this one.
This conference is no longer being recorded.